Hi.
Hello, I'm Fox,
And I'm Jenny.
and we're going to do some cooking for you. Well, I say for you, it's actually for us. It's tasty.
Yeah, and it's gonna be yellow Thai curry.
Well, I call it yellow Thai curry because it's my version of a recipe I read on the back of a yellow Thai curry pot.
It contains yellow Thai curry, so to be
Indeed.
fair.
Whilst I have a Thai friend, I could probably ask. I haven't done that, so we're not getting authentic cuisine at all here. But it is quite tasty, so yes, stick
It's
around.
Fox's yellow Thai curry, and it's very tasty.
I suck at recipes. I'm okay at cooking, but with recipes, I get a few ingredients in before exclaiming something like, "This book's too hard," and giving up, and just making it up as I go along from there. So to overcome this, I'm going to try a new method. Let's see whether this works. I'm going to go with the food elements that need to be in there. You need some white meat, suitable stir-fry veggies, the curry sauce, of course, and what was the last thing? Ah, yes, noodles, slightly crispy by the end. Now, I say slightly crispy by the end because initially they're going to be quite spongy. That's fine. You want them to still got the flavour, but ultimately the final dish is supposed to have the distinctive curry taste. It's supposed to be a little sweet. It's supposed to be nice and crispy and caramelised, and a little bit oily. And if you get this balance just right, it is, oh my, just forget about it. But I'm not too good with ingredients lists, as I said, so I'm going to let Jenny handle what that in terms of what we're doing tonight.
So tonight we're going to be using some fresh leek, some Chinese leek, some cheap bean sprouts, and some water chestnuts that I just wanted to throw in for the hell of it. As for meat, we're using some chicken. It's pre-prepared and pre-diced and everything. Normally, though, we would be using chicken that we cooked ourselves because usually we just buy one big roast chicken and we end up with so much leftover meat. But today we're going with something that was already in the freezer. And of course, we are using yellow Thai curry paste, which you can find in various Asian supermarkets. We're also going to be using some coconut milk and some brown sugar. And finally, there's the cheap noodles. They're just a cheap and nasty kind that you can buy at Lidl or Asda or wherever. They need to be dry because otherwise they don't soak up as much of the moisture as you need. Otherwise, any cheap and nasty noodles will do. It doesn't really matter. They're just there to soak up the juice and then become nice and crispy.
Now, to cook this, I recommend a wok. I do not own a wok, and until I manage to acquire one through some sort of black magic theft, we're going to have to use a frying pan. It's quite deep. Yep, get some oil in there, get the chicken in, and once we're fairly confident it's good enough to go, then we're going to move on to something bigger. Mind out, there's going to be some rattling. Big non-stick pot, and there's going to be a load of vegetables in there, and then they'll boil down over time. But it's got to be quite a deep vessel, that's why I recommend a wok. And a frying pan simply won't do. But you can start with one. First off, we're going to need to get some oil on the go. So, that. Just dump some of that in. That's a fair bit, but that's good. Quite sure what kind of brown sugar this is. Dark brown soft. Either way, it kind of sticks together, but it'll do. Okay, got a whole load of that. Now, at some point in that, I should have put some of the Thai curry paste in. Not masses, just a little bit. The sauce proper happens later. This is more to just give the frying a bit more than sugar and oil. So I'm going to throw that in now. Just a little bit here and there. This could go horribly wrong, but you know, we live and learn. For this, basically, you need about 50 grams of the curry paste. So, I've got some scales here. I'm just going to have to stand up a little further. Let's drop 50 grams in there. 10. Nearly 20, 22, come on.
27, 36. Close enough. 49. Ah, 50. Yeah, there we go. Put that to one side. Okay. Shoot, don't need to. Okay. Coconut milk. I don't really like coconuts, but I love this stuff. Then we basically just mix that stuff together. There'll be a big chunky bit and a load of juice. Remember, then your luck, it'll come out quite clean. Then we stir all that in together and hope for the best. Now this actually already smells delicious and not as oily as you might think, even though there is lots of oil. That's all good. So that, oil and all, in there, get in there, come on. Sniff. Now really it smells amazing. Okay, gonna pile all that in. Put that somewhere. There will have to do. Okay, so we've got the chicken in there. It's nicely cooked, so I think then we're gonna throw in bean sprouts. Should probably have washed them, but too bad. As you may or may not be able to see, there's a huge pile of them. But they simmer down in a bit, so that's just fine. Similarly, I'm gonna pile in other stir-fry things. And it's gonna build up to a huge pile. Pile. As you can see, that's pretty thick. That's not gonna be enough to cover everything, but I'm gonna put some water in. Give me a moment. Okay, so we've got a whole load of water in there. Comme ça. Oh God. That went better than expected. I've not put leek in before, so I don't know what's going to happen. But it looks sort of leafy and stir-fry-y, so that's probably good enough for me. Dear God. Now for Mount Chinese leaf. I can't foresee any issue putting this in. Yep, no problems anticipated whatsoever. This is not going terribly. Oh, that's a plus. Come on. In you go. Few escapees, but for the most part, yeah, there we go. Given that we just cleaned the stove, I think we're okay on that front. In you go. Ah, as you can see, that tops off the vessel. Let's put a lid on it and see what happens.
Just for good measure, I'm going to throw in a bit of soy sauce. Yeah. I tend to use a fair bit, particularly on a dish this large. Unfortunately, we can only get some Amoy stuff, which isn't that good. If you can find some sort of Asian supermarket, you'll find they do these big 500ml bottles that are much thicker and tastier. I'm going to throw the lid back on. And turn up the heat a little. There we go. It's now bubbled up nicely, got a good colour to it. I added a bit more soy sauce, this ridiculously weak stuff. Now I'm going to actually have a look. As you can see, still very watery, but not quite as bad as it was. It's boiling up enough to make me sweat. Saves on salt. And I think it's time to throw some noodles in. There's going to be some crunching noises. I prefer to break them before opening the pack, simply because otherwise they go everywhere. I'm sure they won't for you, but I'm clumsy. Oh, one other thing. You can keep the flavour sachets. I use them for other things when I can't quite put my finger on which flavouring I want. But they're not used in this, so throw them away or put them to one side. Do whatever you want. And as you can see, some caramelization on the go in there. So, now we've got that done, we can turn it off. Let it cool for a few moments, because I find this stuff tastes better a little cooler. But, you know, that's up to you. So after that, in a few minutes, we'll serve up. Although, you're not going to have to wait for that. See you in a minute.
Hey, you have to go away now, because I'm going to eat.
Me too. Mm-hmm. And if you're quick, there's some left in the kitchen for you.
But you have to hurry.
Hurry. It's mine.
No, it's mine.
Bye!